Ms. Martinez? Good morning.
Good morning. Commissioners, my name is Debbie Martinez. I have some good news. You may not have to place another huge property tax onto homeowners to repair our crumbling roadways. The daily 150 diesel belching trucks proposed to haul biomass, congesting and damaging our already fragile roadways, may never happen. The biomass is not a done deal. Voters know we have two attorneys running in the city commission race to stop this financial disaster. Nathan Scopp, at-large candidate, and Ray Washington, District 1 candidate, are absolutely correct. The biomass is not a done deal. They are the only two attorneys running to help us get out of this disaster. The city has a history of getting out of bad contracts, and this is the biggest one ever approved by a city commission. District 1 is the only district that is allowed to vote for both of these attorneys who know how to get out of bad contracts like this. I have spoken to over 3,000 GRU customers over the past 3 to 4 months. I speak for folks who can no longer pay their electric bills. $30 to $40 more every month for an expensive polluting biomass plant we do not need is outrageous. This is not affordable for ordinary folks in Gainesville. GRU customers are telling me City Commissioner Botcher sent out letters crying about the success of both candidates, Nathan Scott and Scopp and Ray Washington, about their ability to capture the number one issue facing voters January 31st, the cancellation of the biomass contract, a 30-year contract for an expensive fuel to generate power we do not need. Commissioner Botcher, along with Mayor Lowe, continue to throw money into the hands of candidates who support the upcoming GRU biomass electric rate hikes. Families will suffer from escalating electric bills. I find this shameful. GRU customers call it corrupt, and they no longer trust the top GRU executives, the mayor or Commissioner Botcher. GRU customers tell me the mayor and Commissioner Botcher are protecting the investors of the biomass project, who will be making millions of dollars off the backs of ordinary folks through skyrocketing electric bills in order to pay for this $3.1 billion biomass plant. Even the contractors of this biomass plant are throwing big money into the hands of candidates who support the upcoming GRU biomass rate hikes. What is next? Wall Street-style bonuses for the GRU top executives? GRU customers are already complaining about the $52 million GRU Taj Mahal complex complete with health spa. As a former downtown business owner, dozens of local businesses tell me this 30-year biomass contract is a financial loser and will drive our city into bankruptcy. Nathan Scopp, at-large candidate, understands giant staggering debt is not a good way to run a utility, because every time the mayor signs a bond, we will have to pay back every single month in our utility bill. Ray Washington, District 1 candidate, understands for less advantaged folks in Gainesville, it is worse. Staying in their homes and staying warm may not be possible for many. Fortunately, the future biomass financial catastrophe is not a done deal. This election is an urgent call to stop one of the biggest mistakes a city commission has ever made. This is why we must vote for both of these attorneys that will be willing and have the knowledge to get out of this bad contract. Vote January 31st, Nathan Scopp at large, the candidate everyone gets to vote for, in Ray Washington, District 1, to stop the upcoming GRU biomass electric rate hikes. And thank you all so much. I really appreciate your kind attention.
Thank you, Ms. Martinez.